other things, like what ATOM is gonna do, like dating and stuff.
Mine is more on what's trending for the teenagers, with the tips, beauty tips, and about my personal likes, like music, traveling, and that's what we're gonna talk about. Not the man. I think the love life side is up to his show. Yes. So.
Thank you.
You can do it.
Thanks for the trust, guys.
Yes. So yeah. Maybe some, yeah, like lifestyle stuff. Like maybe some high school crushes or whatever. But the deeper side should be tackled in the adult
section. Bakit hindi pwede high school?
Level up in Alright. ATOM, right now, you probably are aware that some people are really objectifying you as a person.
Okay, good.
is that okay for you? And a second is also, about dating stuff. Nobody saw you like dating someone else. In the public. will that be out in the open now that you're discussing this online?
Okay, one at a time. The first thing is objectifying.
You.
Please define objectifying.
Well, everybody's in love with you. So is that...
Okay. Pagalang, no, yeah.
Are you... You ask for it.
Kanina objectification lang ngayon, love.
Yeah. I mean, in a sense...
No. Sige, let me try to get a serious answer in.
Alright.
I think objectification is has a lot to do with the gender context. Objectification of women is always problematic. When you switch things around because of current context of society, it's not as bad. In fact, it's sometimes amusing. And if you ask me personally, I find it very amusing. But then again, you have to go back to what kind of effect that has. I really don't know. I mean, it's really up to the people to discuss what kind of net effect that has. Some people say it empowers women also to do the same to men. But on the flip side, baka naman, it means that you can do that willy-nilly, kahit-kahit na lang. So if that happens, you do that to women, that's very problematic to me. So I can laugh about it, it's really no problem, but I hope it kind of opens up a discussion also about how we should
treat
men and women also and online, because this kind of thing happens more free-flowing online. In terms of relationships, which we will tackle in the program, that has to come from a place of truth. So definitely I'm not gonna sit there and like talk from an ivory tower about what people should or shouldn't do. It's also coming from my own experience, but not just my experience, because my experience is very narrow compared to like the broad experience of all people out there who live and love and get their hearts broken. So we're gonna mix it up.
Have you ever had your heart broken?
Sure.
A lot of times.
So what?
A lot of times.
Enough times. Enough times for it to matter.
Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.